the Dizzy Adventure games rock. But what are the spin-off titles featuring the courageous egg like? Let's have a look and find out. First up is Fast Food. This is Dizzy's answer to Pac-Man. Every level consists of a maze containing burgers, pizzas, milkshakes, and chickens. I guess Dizzy has a bad case of the munchies, because he has to grab all the snacks in order to progress to the next stage. That's easier said than done, though, as the food items have a life of their own. To capture a meal, you'll have to chase it down, which is probably what gives the game the title Fast Food. I can accept an egg who wears boxing gloves and rescues damsels in distress, but moving mozzarella's where I draw the line. That's just silly. Anyway, every 3 levels, the player is treated to a mildly amusing clip and earns an extra life. Things start easy and progressively get harder. Come to think of it, things start a little too easy. The first 2 levels are totally devoid of enemies. There's no chance of not completing those stages, unless your joystick is busted and your keyboard is faulty. I can't imagine anyone's that unfortunate. And if they are, how did they manage to load the frigging game? Well, level 3 onwards, you are pitted against some evildoers who are out to get Diz. The game includes 4 different enemies, and each of them have their own personalities. For example, there's one that's quite fast, and there's another one who's smart and tries to cut you off at corners. To help the player out, there are some random power-ups, which include ketchup bottles, which freeze your foes, or a shield, which lets you destroy enemies for a short period of time. I reckon Fast Food is the best of the Dizzy arcade games. It's not a classic by any means, but certainly entertaining. Up next is Quick Snacks, another food-themed Dizzy game. It feels like a sequel to Fast Food, but maybe that's just because they used an identical Dizzy sprite for both games. Like in the Dizzy Adventures, you are expected to free several members of the Yolk Folk who have been captured. For some reason, saving your relatives involves collecting all the pieces of food scattered in a level. No fast food in this one, though. You're expected to collect fruit to clear the stage. Good to see that Dizzy has decided to go for a more healthy diet in this one. I wouldn't like to see him suffer a heart attack. Do eggs have hearts? If you want to earn the highest score, you should collect the flashing fruit first. But it might just be simpler to collect the fruit in any old order. That said, the game isn't all that hard. The enemies which litter the stages are easily dealt with. As you can see, the levels are made up of blocks which Dizzy can push around to trap anyone foolish enough to interfere with his quest. The only thing that will test the player are the bonus stages, which require some thought. You select a direction for Dizzy to move, and he won't stop until he hits a wall. Therefore, you have to plan how to navigate around the course in order to collect all the goodies. Quick Snacks is fun while it lasts, but it's too short and easy. Up next is Panic Dizzy. Codemasters decided that Dizzy should star in a puzzle game, and so Panic Dizzy was born. Not a bad idea from the codies, when you consider that the popular Dizzy games require some thinking to complete. Plus, who doesn't love a good puzzler? Tetris and Puzzle Bobble appeal to most gamers, regardless of age or gender. Unfortunately, Panic Dizzy is not in the same league as those exceptional puzzle games. Dizzy is operating a toy machine in this one, and has to drop shapes in the correct holes. Make a mistake, and the chute, spitting out the shapes, drops down a bit lower, until eventually it hits the ground and it's game over. Or as the game puts it, game under. The trick is to line up the conveyor belt so you can clear multiple shapes at the same time. But who cares? I feel insulted playing this game. It reminds me of those toy buckets which little kids have to fit shapes in to the appropriate hole. I had one of those when growing up, and I didn't use it as it was boring. The same can be said of this game. Bubble Dizzy. Just like Treasure Island Dizzy, our hero has been thrown overboard by pirates. This sets up this platform game, which has Dizzy trying to reach the surface by jumping on bubbles of varying size. The smaller a bubble, the harder it is to land on, but the faster it travels up. I've seen this game reviewed on numerous magazines, and it was awarded a decent grade. I can't really fathom why, though, because I hate it. What's so great about it? You jump on a bubble and hope that it doesn't pop before you reach a ledge. Messing up means Dizzy falls back to the bottom and has to start over. To make matters worse, it's hard to avoid the fishes who are out for an egg supper, as Dizzy moves so slow. Another complaint I have are the graphics. Dizzy looks horrible in this one, and he's always facing left or right, unlike the adventure games, where he looks at the camera when he's not moving. As a Dizzy fan, I'm ashamed that this game was created, and I refuse to talk any more about it. Last on the list is Dizzy Down the Rapids. This, unfortunately, is another lame effort. Dizzy has escaped some trolls by jumping into a barrel which is washing downstream, and now he has to navigate it down the river. Dizzy Down the Rapids? More like Dizzy Down the Crapids. When you hear the word rapids, you think of speed, but this thing chugs along sluggishly. Not to mention the huge delay between when you try to move and when the action registers on the screen. There isn't a lot to talk about in this two-bin rip-off. You avoid obstacles and pelt any hostile creatures with a finite number of apples. Good luck hitting any moving targets, though, thanks to the piss-poor controls. With better level design and some better controls, this might have been an average game at best. But it just smacks of a game which was made in less than a week and had Dizzy slapped on it just to make some cash. What a disgrace. Well, there you have it. Dizzy's 5 Amstrad arcade games. A mixed bag. Fast food and quick snacks are worth a try, especially when you consider that they got released at a budget price. Do yourself a favor, however, and steer clear of the other 3. Thanks for watching, and take care.